chapter on, it is obligatory to recite Al-Fatiha in every rak'ah. If a person cannot recite Al-Fatiha or cannot learn it, then he should recite whatever else he can manage. It was narrated from Ubadah bin As-Samit that the Prophet, peace be upon him, said, "There is no prayer for the one who does not recite the opening of the book, Al-Fatiha." It was narrated that Ubadah bin As-Samit said, "The Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, said, 'There is no prayer for the one who does not recite the essence of the Qur'an, Al-Fatiha.'" It was narrated from Ibn Shihab that Mahmud bin Ar-Rabi', in whose face the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, sprayed water from their well, that Ubadah bin As-Samit told him that the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, said, "There is no prayer for the one who does not recite the Al-Qur'an, essence of the Qur'an, Al-Fatiha." A similar report as Hadith number 876 was narrated from Az-Zuhri with this chain, and he added the phrase, "or more." It was narrated from Al-Ala bin Abdurrahman, from his father, from Abu Hurairah, that the Prophet, peace be upon him, said, "Whoever offers a prayer in which he does not recite the essence of the Qur'an, Al-Fatiha, it is deficient, repeating it 3 times, not complete." It was said to Abu Hurairah, "We are behind the Imam." He said, "Recite it to yourself, for I heard the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, say, 'Allah, Most High, says, I have divided a salah, the prayer, in half between myself and my slave, and my slave will have that which he asks for.' When the slave says, 'Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen,' all the praises and thanks be to Allah, the Lord of the Alameen, mankind, jinn, and all that exists, Allah says, 'My slave has praised me.' When he says, 'Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim,' the Most Gracious, the Most Merciful, Allah says, 'My slave has extolled me.' When he says, 'Maliki Yawmiddin,' the only owner and the only ruling judge of the day of recompense, i.e., the day of resurrection, Allah says, 'My slave has glorified me.' And one occasion, he said, 'My slave has entrusted his affairs to me.' When he says, 'Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in,' 'You alone we worship, and you alone we ask for help, for each and everything,' Allah says, 'This is between me and my slave, and he will have what he asked for.' When he says, 'Ihdina as-sirata al-mustaqim, sirata al-ladhina an'amta alayhim, غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين,' 'Guide us to the straight way, the way of those on whom you have bestowed your grace, not the way of those who earned your anger, nor of those who went astray.' Allah says, 'This is for my slave, and he will have what he asked for.'" Sufyan said, "Al-Ala bin Abdurrahman bin Ya'qub narrated it to me. I entered upon him while he was sick, in his house, and I asked him about it." It was narrated from Al-Ala bin Abdurrahman that he heard Abu As-Sa'ib, the freed slave of Hisham bin Zuhra, say, "I heard Abu Hurairah say, 'The Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, said,'" similar to Hadith number 876. Al-Ala bin Abdurrahman bin Ya'qub narrated that Abu As-Sa'ib, the freed slave of Banu Abdullah bin Hisham bin Zuhra, told him that he heard Abu Hurairah say, "The Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, said, 'Whoever offers a prayer in which he does not recite the essence of the Qur'an,'" a hadith like that of Sufyan, hadith number 878. In their hadith it says, "Allah, the Mighty and Sublime, says, I have divided the prayer into 2 halves, between myself and my slave, 1 half for me, and 1 half for my slave." Al-Ala narrated, "I heard from my father and from Abu As-Sa'ib who were both companions of Abu Huraira. Abu Huraira said, "The Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, said, whoever offers a prayer in which he does not recite the opening of the book, it is deficient," and he said it 3 times. It was narrated from Abu Huraira that the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, said, "There is no prayer without recitation." Abu Huraira said, "What he recited out loud to us, we recite out loud to you, and what he recited quietly, we also recite quietly." It was narrated that Atta said, "Abu Huraira said, in every salah, you should recite from the Quran. What the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, made us hear, we make you hear. And what he recited quietly, we recite quietly." A man said, "Even if I do not recite more than the essence of the Quran, Al-Fatiha," he said, "if you recite more than that, that is better. But if you stop at that, it will suffice you." It was narrated that Atta said, "Abu Huraira said, in every prayer there should be recitation. What the Prophet, peace be upon him, made us hear, we make you hear. And what he recited quietly, we recite quietly. Whoever recites the essence of the book, that is sufficient. And whoever recites more than that, that is better." It was narrated from Abu Huraira that the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, entered the masjid, and a man came in and offered salah. Then he came and greeted the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him. The Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, returned the greeting and said, "Go back and pray, for you have not offered salah." The man went back and offered salah as he had prayed before. Then he came to the Prophet, peace be upon him, and greeted him. And the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, said, "Wa alayka salam." Then he said, "Go back and offer salah, for you have not offered salah." When he had done that 3 times, the man said, "By the one who sent you with the truth, I cannot do more than that. Teach me." He said, "When you stand up for salah, say the takbir, then recite whatever you can of the Quran. Then bow until you are at ease in bowing. Then rise until you are standing up straight. Then prostrate until you are at ease in prostration. Then sit up until you are at ease in sitting. Then do that throughout the entire prayer." It was narrated from Abu Huraira that a man entered the masjid and offered salah, and he quoted a hadith similar to hadith number 885. But he added, "When you stand up to offer salah, perform wudu properly, then turn to face the qibla and say the takbir."